in a little tent. Oh, and just like the river, I've been running ever since. It's been a long time coming, but I know a change gonna come. Oh, yes, it will. It's been too hard living, but I'm afraid to die, 'cause I don't know what's up there beyond the sky. It's been a long time coming, but I know
ready to start this here bed. We got a black baby for sale. Young, healthy black baby. We're gonna start the bed at $20. $20. Got 20, 20, got 20, 20 over there. There go 20, 20. Can I get 30? 30. Get 30 over there? There go 30. 30 right there. 40. Can I get 40? $40 right there. 40. There you go. 40. Right there. $40. All right. Can I get 50? $50. 50. 50. 50 right there. 50 right there. And can I get 60? 60. 60. 60. All right. They already get sold right there to the man in the white hat. $50. Black baby.
Oh, yes, it will. Then I go to my brother. And I say, brother, help me, please. But he winds up knocking me back down on my knees. Oh, there have been times that I thought I couldn't hide.
Generally, the Constitution is a charter of negative liberties. It says what the states can't do to you. It says what the federal government can't do to you. But it doesn't say what the federal government or the state government must do on your behalf.
Obama, 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 Obama.
My president is black, my Lambo's blue, and I be goddamn if my ribs ain't blue.
97.9 The Beat, your interactive hip-hop station. Today is the day, Election Day. Remember this day, put it in your history book, November 4th. I'm Big Bink, what's going on?
Yeah, is there, I'm just calling it about the watch party at Friendship Boys Baptist Church.
Good day, hope I had me a great night. I don't know what you're fishing for, catch your great white. Me, I see great white, heavy as killer whale. I cannot believe this, who knew it came in bail?
All right, we just taking the calls. People getting ready to vote, casting their vote for a shift in consciousness. Your boy Big Bink, what's going on?
Everybody who's riding around in Dallas, Texas, Fort Worth, go vote.
That's right, be a part of history. And who did you vote for, baby?
You already know that. Don't be funny.
Email Jesus, tell him forward to Moses.
All right, we're coming up on the polling place where I'm getting ready to cast my vote for Barack Obama and the Democratic ticket. Looks like it's going to be a light turnout early this morning. Well, maybe not. It looked like we got calls. Well, this could be calls from the school itself. So we're about to find out here in a very short period of time. Northside Elementary School, where I'm getting ready to cast my vote for Barack Obama and the Democratic ticket. I'm making it very well known I'm voting for Barack Obama. He has the better plan, so we're going to see if he can win with my little vote. We'll see what happens, so we'll see you in a minute inside. We're going to go in here, cast our vote for Barack, and then we're going to hit the road and see what other people think. Follow me. I would have thought there would have been some longer lines out here earlier this morning, but unfortunately, people are kind of waiting.
Mr. Obama, the American dream.
You already?
Yes.
You mind talking to us on camera?
I'm kind of nervous.
No, are you okay?
Okay.
go ahead.
Doris Furlow.
What you think about the the elections and how you feel about today. You feel very good?
I feel very good about today. I think it was well organized as compared with last time. And it was just, I was in and out in no time, you know, and I like that.
Were you expecting to see a lot of long lines today?
Yes, I was. I was.
Were you surprised when you got here and you were able to breeze in and breeze out? You mind telling us who you voted for?
Obama. Yo, Obama.
She voted for Obama. You think he's going to win?
I think so.
What do you like about Obama's plan?
I like his educational plan. I just like Obama. His plan for getting the troops out of the war area, mm-hmm. and that he's going to bring about a change. I like that idea. Good. Yes.
What do you think about him being the first African American president?
I think it's fantastic. I really do. I think we're ready to go in that direction now.
Would you consider this a historic day?
Oh, definitely. Definitely. Okay.
Thank you so much. All right. Really appreciate it. All right. Thank you. How y'all doing this morning? Good.
Taking pictures or what?
Oh, yeah.
What are you doing?
We're getting ready to do a film. We're doing a movie on the elections. You want to talk to us?
No, y'all need to get out of here. Y'all need to get out of here.
Oh, we can't film in here?
Uh-uh.
Okay. They wouldn't allow us in with the cameras, but we're going to go someplace else. This is DeSoto, Texas. And we're on our first leg of our bus tour around Dallas today. And we just finished our first stop, which was at Northside Elementary. I cast my vote there. I did a straight Democratic ticket. And now we're on our way to a different location that we were told that there are a lot of people voting in line that have been there for quite some time. And so we're going to go and see if that's true. Okay? Vote or die.
Yeah, I know what that's going to be. It's going to be from Barack all the way.
Like, this is a time in history that a change is taking place. And for the first time in our history, I didn't know that I'd see it in my generation. But I'm glad that the good Lord spared me to be here to see this, take place.
So you voted already?
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Who did you vote for?
Who else? Isn't that obvious?
Who vote
for McCain? I done had enough of the Bush regime.
You done had enough
of Bush? Yeah, that's right.
How do you feel?
And then didn't we vote for Bush, you know, so
how do you feel Barack would do as president if he wins?
Well, I think he's got an uphill battle. I mean, it's understandable that he's going to be fighting a lot of forces are going to be against him right now, because this is a new beginning. And anytime you have a new beginning like this, especially us as a people, we're going, it's a hard road to hoe.
Do you think that he's going to gain the respect and power that's needed as president, as an African-American for the first time in the history of this country?
I think so, because a lot of the foreign countries have been watching this man for the past 8-10 years, and they're seeing the things that change. And I think it would be easier for them to relate to Barack than McCain.
Gotcha.
You see what I'm saying? You know where I'm coming from? And like I say, the time has come for the change, and I'm just glad that I could be here to see it.
Wonderful. Well, it's been great talking with you. We don't want to hold you up. Thank you, sir. Really appreciate it.
All right.
Take care.
All
right. Ms. Logan, tell us, have you voted today already?
I actually voted last week. I voted during the early season.
Okay. You want to tell us who you voted for? Did you vote for McCain?
No, I did not vote for McCain. I voted for Barack.
Good.
I just think that the nation is ready for a change. I don't think that the president himself is going to run the country by himself. That's the reason why I think that when he get the right support staff behind him to delegate and oversee different functions of the government, I think that the whole government is going to work together for the good of the people.
Last question. Do you think today's election will be a landslide or be a very close election?
Well, again, I don't know. They said don't count the chickens before they hatch. What I'm thinking, it is definitely going to be a historical moment. But a landslide, I'm not sure. I'm just waiting to see.
Wonderful. Well, we thank you so much. Really appreciate it. Thank you, Ms. Logan.
You're welcome.
You have a good day. All right, we just leaving Cedar Hill. We interviewed two people over there that had some pretty good comments. Now we're heading over to a place that's supposed to be pretty packed with people, so we're going to see what's happening. Future, and you are too, so Obama. America gonna rock the vote. America gonna rock the vote. You won't change. Hey, y'all done? Okay. So you say you vote for McCain?
No, I voted for Obama.
Tell us what you think about today's historic vote. That's how I'm going to start it out, and then we'll go from there.
It's time for change. You know, we blacks, check the history. You know, we came up through the middle passes. Unlike, it's my reality. Barack is still an African-American. He knows the struggle. He's been there. He lived the struggle. He's a community organizer. He's fighting the Jews. And it's going to bring about change for the whole country, not just for blacks. It's going to be better for the whole country, for everybody, for the working people, for everybody.
So do you think he's going to win?
I think he's going to win. It's going to be tight. It's not going to be easy because of McCain. And this country's come a long way, but some people are not going to vote for him strictly because of his race. But we got enough support, grassroots, from all races. Blacks, white, Asians, African Americans, Hispanic, all. We're going to get votes from everybody.
Okay, you brought it up. You brought race up. So now we might as well talk about it. How you feel about it?
It's come a long way, but, you know, it's racism. People, you're not born prejudiced. You know, people, it's taught. It's taught in the homes, and people had to let it go, you know. Some people are still fighting the Civil War. I ride interstates every day, and I see trucks with the Confederate flags on the front of them. One truck said 18-wheeler had a sign on the back, "No Obama Nation for Me," which had a white driver, which lets you know that people are not going to vote for him just because it's race. But I feel like we're going to get enough of the white vote to win.
So do you think that once he becomes president, he's going to have all power? Do you think they're going to really relinquish the power to the brother?
It's time to bring the power back to the people. The Constitution says for the people, by the people, not for corporations, not for the rich.
We're getting ready to go into my old neck of the woods, which is Oak Cliff, Texas. And talk to some people. We're gonna go by Bob Shop, see what the Bob Shop talk is today. See what they're talking about in the Bob Shop.
All the soldiers, all the guys, soldiers. We at war. We at war with society, racism, terrorism. Terrorism, most of them. We at war with ourselves.
I've been knowing your dad
and
I grew up with him.
Really? I'm telling you, you didn't want to do no interview.
You tell him.
See, I need to get the perspective from the young and the old, everybody.
All right, good man, I met you, man.
Yes, indeed. Can you explain to me why was it deemed correct that we had separate but unequal facilities? How is it that a white person could sit at the lunch counter and we could not? And how is it that a white person could use a bathroom where we're going to urinate and we had to use a different bathroom? Why is that?
Be crawling under your skin and texture if you have. You could read better than the one that had to have a job at that time. Had more education too. They had a man, you had to write your name down on the paper when he first hired me. I started off reading the flow, and the man that was over me, I had to sign my name to it because he couldn't write himself.
Think that by having a African-American president today, a lot of the racism that existed, and oppression that existed, is going to change overnight?
No, it take years back then. It's going to take years now for the lots of people to realize what the knowledge a man have.
The political situation, the political climate now with the elections coming forward, Barack being the first African-American, do you think that's going to open the door up for other African-Americans, and then from this point on we're pretty much going to be African-American presidents elected from here to eternity?
No, it'll take, he might be the only one for the next 20 years have a chance to get to that point.
And that's what you see?
That's what I see, yeah.
What you think about the elections today? How you feel?
It's a great pleasure to have somebody that's running for a country that can make a difference for everybody, not just black, white, Mexican, Chinese, for everybody. And it's going to take a unified a party where we can make the change together. And, you know, through all that, it's a great honor to have a great man to represent our country and to change the economy, economic development that we're having today. And so it's a blessing. And that's pretty much all I have to say.
Right now, we're getting ready to meet
Jade Colbert.
Now, Mr. Colbert, you're a young man. Have you ever seen anything like this before?
First time.
How you feel?
It's a blessing to be a part of it, a blessing to be here to see this.
How is that going to change your feeling and perspective on American culture, society, economics, everything, if Barack is elected tonight?
I mean, that'll just make everything all better to me. I always had strong and positive views as far as our race. But, I mean, that just give other people hope. They say, oh, it won't make a difference if he win. They can't say that anymore.
Now, a lot of people in the hood, especially us, African-Americans, wouldn't vote, probably never have vote. But we coming out now. Why do you think that?
I mean, they see a presidential candidate that they can relate to. I mean, hate to put it on race, but I mean, they can relate to. Now they see that they vote would make a difference if they can get Obama into office.
And so do you think by them participating in the electoral process, that's going to help pull up a lot of people by the bootstraps that have been hopeless and helpless? Do you think that's going to help them?
I think it would help. I mean, it would make them vote. To me, it would make them start coming out to vote instead of being like other years of people thinking they vote wouldn't count. And everybody had their reasons they do and do not vote, but my particular reason that I do vote because of what happened 30, 40 years ago with the black race, with the dogs getting attacked on us.
Turn the water hose on, Billy. Lift them. Set the dogs over. Set them.
11835, code 6, 105 North Avenue
52. I'm so sick and tired, you colors.
We can never be satisfied as long as the Negro is the victim of the unspeakable horrors of police brutality.
11825, code 6, 105 North Avenue 52.
So should we forget and forgive, or should we forgive and not forget?
I mean, we always been a forgiving race. That's just in our spirit. So it's to forgive and move on. Try to better ourselves.
Barack Obama becomes president. January 20th is the day he takes office. Is he going to get the keys?
I hope he do. I hope nothing come up like it did in the Gore situation where some votes was miscounted, wasn't accounted for. I hope he end up being our president.
If you had one closing comment to say to the people that's watching both here and overseas, what would you say?
Your vote do count.
Your
vote counts.
But this guy came up and said he's wanted to do a McCain Barack Obama freestyle right out in front of the barbershop. So we've been ready to go see what he's talking about. Let's check him out.
Well, I got a flow for y'all. I want to let y'all people know y'all need to get out there and vote for Obama. You hear me?
Because the Republicans don't want to see us in stock.
Black people, we do nothing but show love anyway.
We got to hold it down, man. We got to punch the clock.
We need this black president more than anything in our life right now, man.
Get this education proper. Get everything right.
We don't have this black president, man. War never stop.
I can already see the change.
They don't want war to stop. Just like they don't want slavery to stop. But we have a black president, a man that'll step up to stop this.
My name's Jerry and Max, a.k.a. Young Montana, and I approve this message. Barack.
My name is Mr. Erskine, a.k.a. Baby, straight out of Woodtown, and I do approve this mission. Obama.
I'm Mr. Harper, and I approve this message.
Heat it up, keep it up there. Heat it up, get it up, keep it up there.
What it is, how are things? My phone was on solid for a minute, now it rings.
If you do approve that message, we see you, Mr. Williams.
Moving on. New song, new law. Sometimes you can move right and still do wrong. Ain't nothing fancy, just line up and run it. By the time you finish talking about it, I'll be done it. Call it part, bubble spars, do the yin yang thing or anything. I'm just a star. Miss New Booty, thank you, man. Bottom bro brought me back, dog. It's money.
on our way to visit an old neighborhood friend of mine that I grew up with, older family. They're going to give us some perspective on what it's like being older and seeing this generation of young voters come out. So we're going to go by their home now and visit with them. Then we're going to go see the constable. And I approve this message.
On your mind, I see you troubled. I see you worrying in the confines of your mind. What's on your mind? What's on your mind? The man that is born of a woman is a few days, and those days are full of trouble.
Yellow! Come on out.
Am I going to be in the mood?
You going to be in the mood? How you feel about today?
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
So what do you think about Obama becoming the first African American? Who'd you vote for, McCain?
Just in case, turn around the other way, see I have a friend on both sides.
Mm-hmm. Well, that means you got Obama there since you didn't say yeah to McCain. Country messed up.
It's messed up.
Who you think did it?
Well, who been in power for the last 8 years?
The Bushes?
Well, that's all I can say.
Yeah. Let's say, for instance, they steal the election. How you feel about that?
Okay. Hello. Hey. Yeah. I just hope that's not possible. I know anything is possible, but I hope it's not.
That was a quick conversation.
Well, they looking for my wife, not for me.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Is she in here?
No.
Okay. I was over talking both of y'all.
Yeah. George, last name is John, I approve this message.
Well, we just finished up with Mr. George Jones, longtime family friend. Grew up with his kids, and I really just wanted to stop in my old neighborhood and get some perspectives of some of the older generations on how they feel about today's elections. And now we're getting ready to move on to a detail shop, and then we're going to visit up with the constable. This is Eric Williams, and I approve that message.
97.9 The Beat, your interactive hip-hop station, your boy Big Pink. Election day, what's going on?
I just want to put a little message out there, can I?
Put it out there, baby.
Okay, I'm up here in the voting place, right?
Yeah.
So the people, if you push Obama and then you try to go Democrat, you'll knock Obama out. Best way to do, go just straight ticket.
We're getting ready to get out here and try to talk to some of the brothers in the community to see what they had to say about today's historic vote. All right.
Just like this river.
Hey, y'all, brother Stark. Y'all want to talk?
The city of Rockwall was telling people that they couldn't vote.
They were sending out emails saying that all of the Democrats was going to vote tomorrow and not today.
And this was the early vote days.
Really?
Yeah. And it was going on around Rockwall area, Saxey, Wiley.
All the little country town.
All of them out there. There's another one right outside of Rockwall. What's that word red line at? Out there in Roy City. Yeah.
Roy City?
I live in Rolette, and Rolette was trying to pull the same thing.
Yeah, and that's not true. Today is the end of the election.
Exactly.
So how? Well, I hope black folks aren't falling for that. Because you know it was pretty much
not just
geared
blacks,
towards
whoever.
It was whoever.
Yeah, I mean, they were just sending it out as a random email.
The Democratic vote was supposed to be tomorrow.
Right. It's what they told us.
And Republican vote today.
Yeah. They were saying that they needed a voter registration card along with a bill showing where they live, whatever it's called, and also a picture ID, photo ID.
Ain't that nothing.
On an early vote day, all you needed was a driver's license.
That's it.
You could go anywhere.
Ain't that nothing.
Yes.
That's
one of those trickery things.
That's it.
What they do.
Man.
And then, you know, Oprah had that problem. She went to vote, and when she tried to vote straight Democrat, it switched the vote up or something that she was saying she had on her.
Oh, yeah. They're telling something about a button she hit changed all her votes completely.
Right. So she had to go back. She had to go back in there and re-vote. Right. Oprah
can have that problem.
Right.
With the little man going through. So how y'all feel about the whole thing, man? How y'all feel about the fact that we got...
It's time for a change, man. It's time for a change.
The
What kind of change?
Shoot, we need an economic change. Everything Barack talking about is what we need. I ain't with McCain, so I ain't even been listening to what he talking about.
So what you think about McCain?
Man, he not right for this country right now. We need Barack Obama in there. It ain't a black thing, it ain't a white thing, it's a change thing.
But Barack is both black and white.
That's right.
That makes it good, what you say?
Yeah, yeah.
He can relate to,
both sides. That's right.
And I'm glad to hear people saying that it's not a black thing, it's a universal thing.
Nah, I'm trying to eat right now.
Okay, Mr. Johnson, you live here in America. You're not immune to racism and segregation and oppression. You know your history as African American and our people and the struggle we've come through. This is a historic day. This is the first time we get a chance to actually vote for somebody who looked like you and I. How you feel?
A lot of folks were unable to vote, and a lot of folks were able when told they weren't. So, I mean, it means a lot to me to know that someone has enough knowledge and courage to stand up for what they believe in. Yeah.
You voted for McCain?
No.
A lot of times you see these young men running around here with their pants hung down. To me, that's a self-esteem issue. And to me, the self-esteem has been diminished because of the oppression and the racism that has affected them economically, socially, and educationally. By Barack Obama becoming president, do you see that change?
Yes, I do. I see a lot of it changing. Like you say, the main thing is low self-esteem, and then too, again, you know, you have to realize who you are and where you come from. I can be like the Joneses and run in a pack and do the things the Joneses do, but at the end of the day, hey, I'm still me.
Obama wins tonight. What kind of change does he need to make immediately?
The way that they have been treating us on this gas, they're charging us way too much for any and everything they can get their hands on. And I think he need to put some type of cap on the way that they do business as far as the things that we buy from day to day. They blame it all on the gas, but I don't think that's the case at all.
The economy.
Okay.
Barack Obama knows that the economy is falling. He knows that McCain's plan is the same as Bush. What do you see that's different about Barack Obama's plan that's different than McCain's plan?
Oh, God, you kind of got me stumped on that one. I know it won't be the same politics as usual.
By making a preemptive unilateral strike on a sovereign nation like Syria, only is going to provoke our enemies to want to retaliate. And if they retaliate and Bush pushes a button that's going to start another war, constitutionally, he can stay president until he feels the war is over. How do you think that would affect the outcome of a Barack being elected tonight if Bush does that between now and January?
Well, let's hope that he don't do anything that ignorant.
Darrell Johnson, I approve this message.
Miss Johnny, last name is Gray, and I approve this message.
Michael Harris, and I approve this message.
Terrence Terry, I own a terror attack service, and I approve this measure for Barack Obama.
O'clock in the afternoon now. Countdown to the Barack Obama vote. We're getting ready to go in to see if the constable's in, to see if he'll give us our opinion and his perspective of how he feels about today's election. All right.
Jesse Hornbuckle, and I approve this message.
He gonna tell you a little bit about what he saw here at the constable's office.
Well, for the early elections, the lines were wrapped around. As you come in the door, you could see that the lines were wrapped all around the wall, and there was actually no place to park, so you would have to circle around and wait for people to leave. My belief is people came in early and to make sure they had their vote this historic election.
You voted for McCain, right?
Absolutely. McCain, no. Obama, this is a historic event, and I want to make sure when history takes place, I'm on the right side of history. I think that the world, and I've seen this in polls, and I've actually traveled and saw it for myself, that the world is looking for different leadership from the United States through the presidency, and I think people's actions will change.
I'm Harlan Ferguson, and I approve this voting. I'm anxious to vote for the one that's going to do the right thing.
Well, my name is Robert Kendall, and I approve this message.
How do you feel about today's election?
I was going to vote for McCain. You know why?
Why?
One of the things that really made me want to vote for him, because he was willing, when he was a prisoner of war, he was willing to let the other guy go home and stay there 3 more years. Mm. It takes something to do that, you know. Mm-hmm. It takes somebody that's really a strong character to do that. And,
yes.
And, you know, he's a Christian man. He believes in the Lord. He believes we shouldn't kill little children before they, especially before they, the way they do that, they're ready to live and come out and they suck their brains out and kill them, things like that. He don't believe in that kind of stuff, you know. And but I respect him, really respect him for what he did and letting that other man go home and staying there 3 more years. I can't say that I would do that. The other candidate,
Barack,
I respect him for, he really didn't come out and say that he didn't believe in abortion. And that worried me a little. You know, to be president is a hard job.
We have a female on the ticket and an African-American on the ticket. How do you feel about that?
The way things are going in this world, and Jesus Christ is the way, he's the way to heaven. And I like that, because both them guys believe in Jesus Christ as their Savior. And I like that.
This race has not gone without talking about race. How do you feel about race in politics? I mean, there have been a lot of things about Barack Obama being a Muslim, not being a Christian, this, that, and the other. Yeah. And then him being an African American with a white mother and a black father. How you feel about all? Should race play a role in picking a president?
No, it shouldn't. It may. It does some. I'm no doubt it does. But it shouldn't. No, I think Obama is a fine man too. You know, I think he is. He can really tell you stuff.
If Barack wins, would you still support him?
Yeah, I sure would. Sure would.
Well, I'm going to vote for McCain.
Okay.
For he wins or not.
Gotcha.
And I got McCain.
What would be the most influential decision that McCain could make to change the nation right now for you?
Well, McCain, he don't believe in killing innocent babies.
Right.
And I don't think we should commit murder. And he's a Christian. And I believe in God. I believe God has it all in his hands.
Good.
President is black. My Lambo's blue. Baby, goddamn, in my ribs.
Heading to Fort Knox, Dallas, 97.9 Radio 1, located in the Valley View Mall. And so we're looking forward to see what kind of perspective Vita Loca has.
I won't say win, lose, or draw, man, we congratulate y'all already, homie. See, I motivate the thugs, right? You motivate us, homie, that's what it is. It's a hands-on policy. Y'all touching me right, nigga. Yeah, first black president. We lose the trial, nigga. Matter of fact.
So we get ready to go in here and talk to Vita Loca. We'll see you in a minute. We're going to talk to her about what she's heard about the elections here in Dallas so far being on the air. Vita, we're here today to talk to you about the elections today. We've been out to the polls, and the polls seem to appear to be empty. So that may be because early voting has really been effective. What have you heard?
I woke up this morning, like 6 o'clock this morning, anxious, like, ooh, let me see all the lies. Let me see what's going on. Let me see. And I didn't see anything. It was, like, real slow. But they say Texas, 42% of Texas early voted. So that's a major, major amount of people that early voted. And it's so big and spread out, and there's so many voting polls around here that I think it's slow, but I think the right people are getting out and voting.
Barack being elected president, I know you and I have talked a lot about it, and we've had our debates and things of that nature. How do you feel about Barack becoming the first African-American president if he's elected tonight?
I think Barack is intelligent, and I think he's smart, and I think he exudes intelligence. And that's who I want to be a president. Not a black man, an intelligent man who's going to fix my health care and, you know, give me more money and, you know, get all these people and all these businesses back up and running and open these plants back up. We want an intelligent man, you know, because if I were to say, you know, oh, that was a great white man that won, I would feel very uneasy if I heard people say that. And I don't care about the reason that he's black, because our black children need to know that they can do anything they want to do, because it's not because of your color. It is because of your character and how bad you want it, you know? So I just don't want to get hung up on this, he's black, and that's that, you know, kind of mentality. I want people to understand that color is not an issue. It is issues that are the issues, and I think he's the right man for my issues.
So you voted for McCain?
Yes.
McCain and Sarah Palin.
Look, I don't make over $200 million a year. So, but when I do, you best believe I may be voting for McCain, okay? If I make $500,000 a year, I'd be like, I don't know what you're talking about.
I got
to watch my money.
Yeah.
Okay?
Yeah,
but I don't, and so I'm voting on my issues.
Good. Hey, final remarks to the people that will be watching this program.
Vote for the right man, not the white man or the black man. Vote for the right man. That's just it. Vote for the right man. Because it might be a Mexican one year.
So we're going to say goodbye to Vita and thank her for her time.
Thank you.
Thank you, Vita. All right, love.
Thank you, E.
Okay, all right. We're in the house with DJ Big Bink. He's going to give you his first and last name. He's going to tell you at the end of his first and last name, he approved his message. Bam.
It's DJ Big Bink, and I approved his message. It's real tough.
All right, here we go. All right, so Big Bink is responsible for Barack Obama becoming president, right or wrong?
That's right, man. I had to go out there and make sure. Even though, you know, I was looking at a lot of stuff that the media was saying about Texas is a red state, I wanted to make sure that I got out and cast my vote so the black vote, Latino vote, minority vote would have a high percentage today.
Well, you heard it from DJ Big Bink. We're out of time now. We want to give our much love to Candy and our 3 minutes that he allotted us for both parties. And we just want to say thank you to DJ Big Bink. Keep doing a good job here at 97.9, and we'll see you soon.
Hey, but this is, you know, something that I want to touch on before we go. I thank myself, and I thank everybody who went out to A, early vote, B, vote in this historic election. Believe it or not, on the radio show today, I had people, I kind of flipped it, because everybody was saying, vote, and that's cool. But I wanted to talk to the person that went through to get registered and said that they didn't want to vote. I wanted to know why. You know what I'm saying? So thank you for everybody who made it a part to be in this historic election.
Obama is for change, go jump on the
feel tonight?
I'm just so overwhelmed. I'm just so overexcited. I'm just, you know, just to listen to my mother, my parents, my grandmother, just some of the things that, you know, they had to go through back in the, you know, the 67s and, you know, 68. I'm just overwhelmed, you know, because now I see that, you know, voting does make a difference. My children, my grandchildren, you know, this really is just a historical thing for them. I'm just glad, you know, there's nothing like my, you know, race of people to be in office. And Barack Obama, I mean, just with his message, it's just a touching message.
What was you thinking when you voted for Barack?
What I was thinking was, this is done. You know, Martin Luther King, you know, his message is just so strong and just so deep if you just listen to it, you know. Let freedom ring. You know, it's just me standing there trying to cast my vote. You know, it's just I have to actually look at the ballot, you know, again before I just actually cast my vote just to make sure I was voting for Barack Obama. And with me hitting that button saying vote, 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 you know, all I can see again is change.
What would be your closing comments and remarks you would say to the people?
I would have to say that this is a rejoicing moment for the world. Change will come, but again, Barack Obama can't do it alone. This is just the start of what's about to happen with change. We definitely still have to do our part to back him and all that he's said that he would do for the United States of America.
What do you think America would be like if we have a repeat of what happened to Dr. Martin Luther King once Barack Obama is elected?
Hey, I'll be honest with you. I think it would be total, total chaos. I mean, it just would be, it would be really, really bad. Something I don't want to witness. And I pray for his safety and pray for everyone's safety and just hope the world is a better world than it was back then. Something I wasn't able to witness because of my age, but I am witnessing now, and I just hope and pray for his safety because it would be a bad deal. I really believe, honest to God truth, it would be really, really bad.
Well, great, bro. Appreciate it.
Thanks, boss.
All right. Thank you. Barack Obama wins the presidency tonight. He inherits the Bush legacy and the administration of the Bush. All the problems that Bush has that we all agree that needs to be corrected. How do you think that's going to affect him as the first African American? You know, a lot of times we'll inherit things that are messed up and then they want to blame us. How would you deal with that issue?
Well, actually, I think that he's been blessed, and I think that his administration will be blessed, and as a result, that no matter what, no matter the problems of the Bush administration, we're going to see a difference, and we'll vote for him again in 4 more years, and he will go down in history as an effective executive.
You didn't feel a sense of pride to vote for McCain with Sarah Palin versus Barack Obama?
Not at all. She is an embarrassment. She's not qualified. She doesn't represent women. She certainly doesn't represent me. And not just the fact that she's white, but that she's conservative, her intellect. I think that if you're going to be in a position, you should be able to uphold that position. You should be an example and not just somebody that's plugged in. So absolutely not.
If you had one thing to say to America and the people that are going to be watching this film overseas, what would you tell them?
Thank God Barack Obama's our president, I guess.
Raining from our eyes, never knowing when it's gonna stop. Every drop splatters into a pool of thought, drowning into dreams that we so often sought of being great and our time given on earth. Something locked inside our mind and soul since birth. A chromosome genetic curse that plays in our mind without rehearse. Fame and fortune is what we hunt, but blocking our path is a waterfall of lies, jealousy, and those who front. But to those gestures, it's just a notion, cause our destiny is pre-written. We just physically go through the motions. Instigation through false men, whom would rather see us lose than win. Born with the precious gift of sight, but too blind to see that helping each other's the key. I'm so tired of trying, so tired of crying. Finally, our tears just start dying, because the dirt to turn to mud, causing our teardrops to turn to blood. But we won't fall victim to being weak. We won't stop till the tear with the reflection of our image drops, bursting open into a brilliant display of art, bringing into the light that was for so long hidden in the dark, that our image would plunge through a translucent drop, protruding that we were destined to be on top.
God soldiers, we at war. We at war with society, racism, terrorism, mostly though. We at war with ourselves.
God show me the way, because the devil trying to break me down. Know what the Midwest is, young and restless, but restless.
Nigga.
Might snatch your necklace, and next day, might jack your Lexus. Somebody tell you who Kanye West is. I walk through the valley of the shy where death is. Top floor, if you alone, I leave you breathless. Try to catch it. It's kinda hard getting choked by detectives. Yeah, now check the method. They be asking this question. The basis, we ain't going nowhere but gets.